right-wing group that has been cited heavily in Dinesh D'Souza's documentary about voter fraud has now admitted to a Georgia judge that there is zero evidence to support the claims of illegal ballot stuffing during the 2020 presidential election. So here's how we got here. Texas-based True the Vote filed complaints with Georgia Secretary of State Brad Raffensperger in 2021, including one in which it said it had obtained a detailed account of coordinated efforts to collect and deposit ballots in drop boxes across the Metro Atlanta or across Metro Atlanta during the November 2020 election and a January 2021 runoff. Now, a judge in Atlanta signed an order last year requiring True the Vote to provide the evidence that they had collected to back up their claims, including the names of people who were sources of information to state elections officials. The group had been refusing to share the evidence with investigators. When pressed to provide the names of sources and other documentation, the group last year tried to withdraw their complaint. They're like, yeah, you know what, we're gonna withdraw the complaint instead of provide the evidence we claim we have. Well, the state election board refused to shelve the complaint and instead went to court to force True the Vote to share the evidence they have, calling their bluff. Show us the paper, show us the evidence. Well, in their written response, attorneys for True the Vote said the group had no names or other documentary evidence to share.
Oops.
There's more. The group came up empty-handed despite having made every additional reasonable effort to locate responsive items. Its attorneys David Oles and Michael Wynn wrote in a December 11th legal filing, first reported Wednesday by the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. In addition to names, the judge ordered True the Vote to provide copies of any confidentiality agreements it had with sources. The group's attorneys replied to that by saying, TTV, meaning True the Vote, has no such documents in its possession, custody, or control.
Yeah.
We might have millions of people watching this show, but you can be the difference maker, because we just need 1% of our audience to be paid members, and then this show can be around forever. So you can make that difference. Click join now. Let's note that it was called True the Vote, and it turns out they were lying the entire time. So I'm sick of this, but because it's poisoned the minds of so many innocent Americans, and by those I mean actually right wingers. Like, the left wing is not poisoned by True the Vote. They know that those guys are full of crap. We saw Donald Trump go to court 60 times after the election, lose every single time, present no evidence. And a lot of independents have seen it. They've seen him lose over and over again in court because he never has any evidence. The right wing, when they go to court, never, ever, ever, ever have any evidence, right? Rudy Giuliani, no evidence. Your Honor, no evidence, right? Mm-hmm. So, but for, and if you hate MAGA and you think they're all evil and satanic, no, there's good reasons to be deeply frustrated and maybe even dislike a significant portion of MAGA, right? But there is a chunk of MAGA that genuinely believed that the election was stolen, and they were super mad about it because they thought democracy was taken away from them.
Some of them engaged in actions on January 6th that ended up getting them arrested, convicted, and sent to prison for a long period of time, which is pretty tragic.
What's interesting is that a lot of them then, when they went to court and they realized, talking to their lawyers, etc., that there was no evidence, they're like, oh no, I got lied to, now I'm gonna go to prison for Trump and these guys who totally lied to me, right?
Yep. And by the way, like, here's another thing that happened. So apparently True the Vote didn't even know the name of their own source. They didn't know the identity of their own anonymous source who told a story of a ballot trafficking scheme allegedly organized by a network of unnamed groups paying $10 per ballot delivered.
Yeah, so where's the mules? Where's the mules? There's no mules. It was always a lie. It was meant to deceive not the left, but the right. Do you see how those leaders, including Trump, Dinesh D'Souza, the guys who ran True the Vote, are trying to trick the right wing? They think, oh, I will use them as suckers.
They're manipulating them.
Yeah, they're manipulating you. And when they're in court, zero evidence, as always.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.